my third grade teacher was bad. I'm just gonna say she was bad. She considered that I was talkative, and she put me in. She had a cubicle. She had a cubicle in her room, and that was what she called isolation. And she put me in isolation. There was a desk in there, and that's where I was all day. I had to turn my schoolwork in separately. She would not call on me in class. She would not answer questions. Yet somehow I still continued to get in trouble in isolation when I had no communication with anybody. I had to write sentences. Okay, writing sentences, not that big of a deal, right? But, I mean, this was a repeated, continual, ongoing thing. And my mom wasn't a fan of writing sentences. She was one that believed you go pull a dictionary out and copy it, or something that's like educational, and write that if you're going to have to write. But that's neither here nor there. What it came down to is my mom worked in the public school system, and she was really afraid to ruffle feathers. She was afraid she'd lose her job. But this teacher was really downright abusive with me. So my mom pulled me out, and that's how I ended up in private school. Private school was no better, other than I guess the teachers were a better thing, but the students, I mean, I was bullied relentlessly that entire time. I was so glad at the end of seventh grade my mom said I could go back to public school. At this point, we had moved and I was in a completely different district, so it worked out, and I don't regret going to the private Christian school. But I don't think I'd ever send my kids ever. Yeah, that's why we homeschool.